Hello students, I hope every one of you are doing fine. Today we are going to discuss the topic hashing. Before we understand hashing, we have to understand a term called associative arrays. What is an associative array? An associative array is a kind of data structure which is similar to that of an array but are not indexed by integers. That means the elements are just not only indexed by integers, they can be indexed by different kinds of data types such as strings, such as alphabets or many different kinds of indexing. So to understand this, what we do is that we'll take an example. I will consider, a class where there are many different students and each student has its own unique student ID. And if I want to store the grades against a particular student ID, then the student ID in my associative array will be the index and the grade will be its corresponding value or data value, right? We can take another example, like if I want to assign, or if I have assigned a unique assignment to all the students in my class, then after completing or after the submission of assignments, I want to assign some grade score to each of the assignments. Then the name of the assignment in this case will be that again the index of the associative array, and the corresponding data value will be the grades against this each and individual assignment, right? So the associative array does not always uses indexing or does not always uses integer to index its own elements, right? So the associative arrays are the arrays which are required for the purpose of hashing. What is hashing? Hashing is a technique which is used for storing and retrieving information as quickly as possible, right? So now, why hashing? Why hashing? Because if we use hashing, or if we are just using an array, right? If we are just using an array, then in this array, we will have several different indices starting from 0 till n minus 1. So there are total n different elements that can be stored in this array. Now, if I want to find out a certain element, say the data value that I want to, that I stored in n minus 1 or the last index location of the array, say that value is d1. And in order to search this particular value d1, I have to traverse the entire indices. I have to traverse the entire array in order to reach to d1, right? This is the simple process which is also known as linear search technique. So this technique almost requires you a time of big O of n, right? This is the upper bound that it may require. That is, the value that you're going to find is located in the last index of the element or in the last index of the array. But what if I can find this particular d1 in just big O of one time? That is, if I know how, by which formula or by which technique, if I have a certain technique to actually store d1 in an array, then in order to fetch, or while we want to fetch d1 again, then we will use the same technique in order to fetch that d1 from that location. This is the purpose of hashing. Hashing uses some kind of formulas which actually helps to store a certain number using that particular formula, and then when it is needed again, that particular data value can be retrieved using that same formula, and the data value can be retrieved in just big O of one time. Right? So obviously you can understand that if I have to search d1 in a linear array using linear search technique and it requires big O of n time, and if I use the same thing using hashing, I can retrieve it in big O of one time, then obviously we have to think about this particular concept known as hashing. Obviously there can be some situations when the d1 item, in case of hashing as well, in the worst case can take big O of n time. The question may arise that how is it so possible? We will not discuss about its possibility right now, because when we will discuss more in detail about hashing, we will come to this point and we will discuss and you will understand why the big O of n time may be required, right? So for the time now, we will understand that the hashing in its best and average case requires big O of one time, and its worst case can be obviously big O of n time. So obviously in both the cases, best and average case, the time required is big O of one time. But in case of linear service, the average time complexity will be again big O of n time. So obviously we will still prefer using hashing. So we will obviously think about the concept of hashing in order to store or retrieve information. Now we have to understand hashing. Now how to understand hashing? This is a brief introduction about what a hashing is and why we actually need hashing. Now we come to the part that how we actually can understand hashing. I will take a simple problem. The problem says you have to find the first repeated character. Suppose you have taken a lot of different characters in the form of a string from the user. And now the problem is given to you as that you have to find the first repeated character, right, in the entire string. The very simple process is to use the brute force approach, where you take individual characters and then compare with all the characters of the array and then find whether this character is repeated in the entire array or not. For very first element, which will have its duplicate entry, in any other index of the array, will be the element which is the first element that is to be repeated. But whatever you do, that particular technique is going to take you big O of n squared time, because you take a single character in an array and then you start comparing this character with each and individual locations of the array. That means a single element is being compared with almost n different elements. That means with n different elements, we will compare n into n, which gives you n squared time, right? So the entire comparison now takes big O of n squared. What if we can find a better solution to this problem, right? So what we do is, we know that there are total 256 different characters. What we will do? We will form an array which will contain 256 different elements or 256 different location, right? 0 to 255, right? The string that is being supplied to you by the user contain characters within this particular domain, obviously. Now, when you take a character, when you encounter a character, say the character value A or the character is capital A. If it is capital A, we know that the ASCII value of capital A is 65, right? What we do is that after we create this array, we initialize each and every location with value 0. Now, if the first character is A, we go to 65th location or 65th index of this array, and we then increment the counter value by 1, right? Now, if we increment the counter value by 1, then for the first character, say the next character is B, that means B is having an ASCII value of 66. So suppose this particular location is 65 and this one is 66. So obviously I will increment the value of 65 to 1 and 66 is still 0. Now when we encounter the character B, which is the next character of the input string, then we increment the value 0 to 1 in the 66th index position as well. Now what if the third character is A? Now if the third character is A, then obviously we will increment this 65th location to its one incremented value. That means it is incremented by 1, that is it's 2. So whenever any increment or whenever the count value of any index goes from 1 to 2, that means that is the very first character which is repeated in the entire string, and that's what the problem was. You have to find the first repeated character in the entire string. The previous method that we have used was using a brute force approach, but in case of this particular technique, we are keeping a track of all the previous characters that we have already encountered by keeping a counter value, that how many times that we have encountered that particular character using the ASCII values. So obviously when you get A again, the value of A or the counter value of A goes from 1 to 2. That means it is the very first character which is repeated in the entire string. So obviously in order to perform this particular task, we only require big O of n. We have to understand the topic hashing because it helps us to store and retrieve information much faster than what we could have done it using a simple array.